least 200 Chinese investment proposals are awaiting security clearance from India's Home Ministry. This comes after India changed its foreign direct investment rules in the month of April to protect crisis-hit domestic companies from hostile foreign takeovers during the pandemic. The new FDI rules have made prior government approval mandatory for countries which share a land border with India. A report said that the Home Ministry has received 200 proposals from China since the month of April. However, none of them has been approved yet. Earlier, the government's permission was required only in crucial sectors like defense, telecommunication, and mining. Before the month of April, companies had to just notify the Reserve Bank of India. Earlier this year, concerns were raised when Chinese Central Bank announced that it has bought stake in Indian lender HDFC. The rules are unlikely to be eased anytime soon as tensions remain high along the India-China border. And now we have our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibbal, joining us live here on We On Dispatch, straight from India's capital, New Delhi. Siddhant, talk to us. This is an important development considering the decision India took about companies from countries that share a land border with it.
Well, yes, Krishna, it's an important decision, but not a surprising decision given the fact that it looks like a policy is being put in place regarding investment or data security from China. Regarding the apps, we know that Indian government, just weeks after the Galwan incident in which the Indian army lost 20 of its soldiers, announced that it is banning 59 Chinese apps, including the famous TikTok app. And then thereafter, this decision being announced, 47 apps being banned, the Chinese apps being banned. But by and large, these apps are clone version of the 59 apps which are banned, including cameras, scanner, and of course TikTok Lite and other of these apps. But by and large, we know that when it comes to investment as well, the Indian government has been tightening the process of investment coming from China. In fact, just last week, when it comes to public procurement, the Indian government announced that the Chinese companies will have to face more scrutiny. There was, of course, no mention of China, but the fact that India mentioned all the countries which share land border with India will have to go through a security measure, which includes a review by the Indian Interior Ministry, that is the Home Ministry and the MHA. But by and large, we know that this is going to be and expected to be a loss for China, given the fact that it loses share in one of the largest markets on the planet. And of course, we have seen what India did has acted as a so-called inspiration for other countries as well. In fact, the U.S. government, the U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, publicly lauded India's decision to ban these apps. And now it seems that other countries are taking a cue from that. In fact, Australia, Japan, U.S., a concert of democracies can be seen when it comes to the increased Chinese aggressiveness in the region and across the world, and also blocs like the EU and the ASEAN. So it will be a difficult moment and a period for China, because political actions by Beijing are going to translate into strong actions by other countries, especially when it comes to investment, commerce. Right. And if China believes that it is the next superpower, it looks like it's going to face a lot of tough and difficult problems globally when it comes to investment.